So the culture here at the Faculty of Engineering, I think, is unique in some sense that the doors are always open to the professors. And the professors are very passionate and engaged, and you have a regular contact. The fortunate thing we have here, we have extremely passionate teachers that are also excellent researchers. So we have the benefit of incorporating the last research into the courses on a yearly basis. It's a common thread that all courses collaborate closely with industry, and the industry is super interested to come and meet the students. Already from the start, we have seminars with companies, we have projects where we work with real cases and solve real-life problems in companies. So it's very much bridging practice and theory, and we do it together with industry. In the end, there is a close connection between the students and the future employers.
So this program was established mostly because we see a shortage in Swedish industry for engineers within manufacturing. So we want to supply both the Swedish industry but also international industry with students that know how should we produce and how should we realize products in a good way. And that in both in times of quality but also to ensure a sustainable future for manufacturing. So we are focusing on how to make efficient production, how do we make sure that we utilize the resources that we have, and also what is the impact of the material selection that we do in our products.
You do a lot of hands-on things. You really, if you do an education in chemistry, you really work at the lab a lot. And the same goes, of course, for education in mechanical engineering or whatever it is, that you really do hands-on work. You will not come to Lund and do only theoretical work. We have elective courses, and we also have very open elective courses, and they are chosen, of course, to be compatible or to broaden the program. And there are, I think, different philosophies on the different programs. One strength of LTH is that we are a part of the big university, which have basically all subjects represented, and in principle, you have access to many courses at Lund University.
Basically, they teach you the foundations of virtuality and augmented reality. So for the first year of the program, we're introduced to computer graphics, as well as image analysis and design, interaction design, universal design. I would say in the program, there's a lot of focus on collaboration, especially with design courses, and also collaboration across disciplines, which is the idea of the universal design course, where you work with other people in the Faculty of Engineering, as well as industrial design students. And even in the computer science courses, there is encouragement to, of course, work with pairs, and even in mathematics, the computer vision, which is kind of a mathematics course, they encourage you also to work with others. So I would say definitely a huge focus on it. To be honest, with my cohort this year, like, it kind of feels like a big family. We celebrate things, we share news. It's a very friendly environment, I would say.
We have created a rather unique program in disaster risk management and climate change adaptation, because we focus on the proactive approaches and how to avoid the different events that may have a negative effect on what we value. I would say our program focuses mainly on risk safety, but we also need sustainability. But the core focus, it is disaster risk management and climate change adaptation to deal with the negative side effects of climate change. So in the classroom, with the students and teaching staff, there's a lot of interaction and discussions going on with the purpose to have a mutual learning. We learn from each other. But we also need to think outside the box and challenge our already existing knowledge, so to say.
We have a lot of teamwork. Students are always, in every course, joining groups of study, groups of work, where they have assignments, they have to solve problems together. And then we have a mix of students from different study cultures, from different backgrounds, from different nationalities, and from different academic backgrounds also. So they kind of complement each other in the group. So we as a teachers, we are trying to facilitate that collaboration. We have put a lot of emphasis on new trends yeah, vegan products and mostly protein diversification concept, yeah, that you should try to replace animal proteins by plant-based proteins is a big, big trend in food science right now. So we are trying to make students think and work on these trends, yeah, what the food industry is really interested on right now, yeah.
It's a two-year master program, and we have some mandatory courses, and we have some elective courses. There's a focus on food technology, you know, food microbiology, food chemistry. There is also, like, if you want to take some courses that are in environmental sciences or, you know, more in-depth in food microbiology, that's how it's structured. The courses that we take are very, you know, they have cutting-edge technologies. There's a lot of research. The professors do a lot of research, so I think we would be great additions to any company with the knowledge that we've gained here in the program.